Blackstone Audio presents Final Destination, Disaster. What Really Happened to Eastern Airlines by George Jehn. This book is read by Joe Barrett. Legal Disclaimer. Note. In this book, the author is referring only to events surrounding the airline company then known as Eastern Airlines that ceased operating in 1991. In no way does the information herein reflect in any way or in any manner upon any new airline or other entity which may start up at some time in the future with the same name and utilize the same or similar advertising or trademarks as the airline that ceased operations in 1991. To the many thousands of former Eastern employees who never knew the complexity of the events surrounding them, but who paid dearly. Prologue. On January 1, 1985, at approximately 8:38 p.m., an Eastern Airlines Boeing 727 Flight 980, piloted by Captain Larry Campbell, on a routine flight from Asunción, Paraguay to La Paz, Bolivia, crashed into the Andes Mountains outside the La Paz, Bolivia, John F. Kennedy International Airport. All 29 souls on board were killed. Normally, following any airliner crash, an extensive probe to determine the cause would be undertaken by the investigative agencies of the countries involved, in this case, the United States and Bolivia, as well as Eastern Airlines and other interested parties. But this time, no timely inquiry was ever launched, even though public statements to the contrary, emanating from the highest government and Eastern sources, were widely, and as I subsequently discovered, deceptively, circulated. Some victims' relatives, frustrated by this inaction, wanted to embark on their own trek to the crash site. They were eventually dissuaded by one Eastern pilot, who mounted his own expedition to try to get some answers. Meanwhile, the U.S. government's and Eastern's delaying tactics helped ensure that the reasons for the crash would remain forever buried on a barren and bleak South American mountainside. 11 months later, winter had again arrived in the Northeast, and while sitting in the cozy warmth of my study in front of a blazing fire on a bitter cold December evening, I delved into the United States National Transportation Safety Board, NTSB, papers that were finally issued on the Flight 980 crash. The more I read, the more troubled I became. I envisioned the pitch-black sky on that fateful night, only illuminated intermittently by lightning crackling from a thunderstorm visible on the jet's radar directly ahead, and pictured the frigid snow swirling beneath the 727 like a stealthy whirlwind in a silent, desolate landscape more than 19,000 feet above sea level. The closest bastion of warmth was the flight's next stopover, La Paz, a little over 50 miles away and closing fast. But Flight 980 never made it there, its final and silent tomb, instead a windswept ridge in the Bolivian Andes. I wondered what might have transpired in the final moments between the pilot's acknowledgement of a descent clearance to 18,000 feet in preparation for landing at La Paz and the jet's devastating impact with Mount Illimani. At the time, as a 16-year veteran Eastern pilot, I was very troubled, first by the NTSB's initial refusal to conduct any investigation, then after they were forced to do so, their inexplicable delay of over 10 months to even send an expedition to the crash site. I had just finished poring over the partially redacted NTSB after-action report on this useless trek, which raised more questions than any it possibly answered. Never before had I witnessed so many uninvestigated possible causes and unanswered questions in light of such a serious disaster. There were too many contradictions, too much information that was conveniently ignored, overlooked, or simply cast aside, never to be examined by that U.S. government agency, at least not publicly. No one had lifted a finger to discover what had really caused this crash. Deepening the mystery, this was the only time since the founding of NTSB that the cause of a crash of a United States commercial jet airliner had not undergone intense scrutiny. In addition, other Eastern pilots had subsequently reported a number of close calls on their South American flights. Although it was these items that originally aroused my interest, I discovered that indeed there was more. Something was very different about the manner in which the Flight 980 disaster was handled, or mishandled.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.